real quick, because I have to get out of here. I've got to go. Hi, mate, you're
right. Eddie, what? AJ came over here looking, you know, talking to other trainers and stuff. I heard on the IFL interview, he basically said something about, you know, he's tired of losing, wants to bring back the dog and stuff. What do you think changed? What was different about the Usyk loss as opposed to like the Andy Ruiz loss that now this new mentality is coming out?
Obviously, it's the second one. So the first one, you could kind of say, you know, that was a bit of a freak loss. My preparation wasn't good. Got hit on the top of the head, etc. But you know, I think that's my fault. That's my job, though.
Okay, I'm saying it.
I know.
But that's not our job because we don't do rematch.
It doesn't matter to you, though.
Yeah, because it matters.
But when you're promoting it the right way,
because now we got to think about if you're gonna win or not.
No, because it would matter to you if he. You know.
All right, so okay, right here. You got me a camera. I called Mauricio Sulaiman, and I told him to do a petition for Devin Haney to sign the petition.
Yeah.
Okay, could he do it right now, or he has to wait after the fight? Okay, so why are you waiting?
Yeah, I mean, Mauricio.
But Mauricio already said it.
He's never said it to me in his life.
He said it on national TV.
Yeah, but no one talks to me about it.
Is Mauricio here?
You talk about these things like the Bob Arum interview.
No.
No one talks to me.
I told Mauricio to go on national TV and tell the people that all the Haney's got to do is sign the petition. You heard this.
But we got the convention.
It's all over.
We're ready to do it.
It's all over. It's all over the news. Everybody knows. You knew about it, right? I know you knew about it. Everybody knows about it. So let him sign it.
Petition already. Yeah. I'm ready to eat that dog, man. I'm ready to eat.
No, sir. Mostly everybody knows about the petition. You know what I'm saying? Let them sign it. We can make it. We can seal it. We can make it mandatory.
What's going to happen, right, is this is what's going to happen. Let me tell you.
I got Kamboses. He's going to be Judge of the Years. Then we make the fight happen.
Then what we're going to do is we're going to go then to Bob, and I'm going to go, Bob, I want to make this fight, right?
Bob said it's okay.
Yeah, but,
he's not saying that.
If he doesn't want to pay for it, I'll pay for it.
Exactly.
There you go.
So you win. You win twice. You win three times, you know? And I wouldn't have no say so about that.
Wait. I got to step in, though.
Get in the middle, kill.
I got to step. No. I'm staying right here. But ESPN will fight for it too.
They can have it. We can do it on ESPN. We can do it on both.
In association with ESPN. That's
I like that.
If it's the right deal for everybody, yes. We can do it on ESPN.
If everybody's going to win.
We can put it on both. And if Bob don't want to pay for it, I'll pay for it.
Understand?
Yeah. Right? And we believe you. Said, and we believe
it's a pleasure
you.
To have
you on design. You're a man of your word. Have I only talked good things about this guy the whole interview?
Yes.
But that
yes.
has been an honor that he's a gentleman.
Thank you.
The whole time. You know?
Listen,
if we're going to build a fight,
I want to say this. And while we're giving each other compliments, I want to say this. I was looking at your son in the ring earlier, and I thought to myself, that's the guy that beat Lomachenko. Right. I feel like he should get a lot more praise for what he did.
Course.
Because when he beat Richard Comey, and they said, yeah, he's going to fight Lomachenko, I said, he ain't going to fight Lomachenko. What a stupid decision. Because this kid's a star. He's just had a great win at MSG. They should build him. They should have a couple of defences and make that fight even bigger. Yet you had the balls to go and fight Lomachenko.
And get the lesser price.
And probably take not as much money as you should have done.
Yeah.
Man, I went home with like $600,000 that fucking
night. My heart bleeds.
The whole world doesn't need to know that.
My heart bleeds.
And I live off of a fucking budget, but I love it. You know why? Because that's how the billionaires do it. So I'm actually thankful.
My dad always says to me, always live poor.
Yeah, you gotta live poor. But that's why I work my butt off over here.
But what I'm saying to you is you should have been the star of ESPN.
Of course, and we are.
Maybe you will be.
But I'm saying, after that performance,
for what you achieved, you should be a superstar.
I'll say like this, though. Like, everything connects in this way. He's a businessman. He knows what he wants and what he's doing. Matchroom Boxing, he holds that, right?
Yeah.
Takeover Promotions is coming in, right? So all the things, like, we'll talk in 2 years after my ESPN deal.
But the one thing I'll tell you about Takeover Promotions,
yes.
Which is the same thing I'll tell you about Devin Haney Promotions, and the same thing I'll tell you about Canelo Promotions, is all these promotional companies, the one thing they don't want to do is take any risk.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
because this is what bigger promoters do.
Of course.
And it's a tough business.
He's talking about rematch clause.
No, I'm not talking about that.
You gotta know,
I'm talking about the risk that's on the show.
Yes.
So as I always say to Bill and Devin, so if this show loses $1 million and you're my co-promoter, are you in for half?
Oh, But you got to.
But I want to ask you a question.
I say it like this though. Yeah. Investing, sorry, Pa. Investing, you have to, in order to invest, you have to lose first before you gain.
Did my advice to you?
I invested in myself. Yeah, I took whatever I had to take.
Don't invest.
But I'm not going to take
invest
I'm not going to
shows.
Okay.
Let the promoters lose the money.
No, yeah, of course.
Just make sure you get the right deal.
Yes, of course. I mean, I get 70% net.
Yeah, so.
don't worry about it, bro.
Hey, no, but it's all good.
But anyway, I gotta say something, and it's something that I loved about what Eddie said. Who's the boss?
Yeah.
Who's the boss?
You're the boss. Well, not you.
Not me.
He's the boss.
Okay.
This is what
the
I say.
Fighters are the boss.
The older generation, and even my dad included. You know.
You sure your dad ain't gonna kill you for this?
No, he's fine. Because he said it before. They come from an era where the fighters work for the promoter. That don't exist.
Yeah.
We work for the fighters. It doesn't matter
they lose
whether
their lives
it's you
in there,
or whether it's a 6-round fight for someone turning professional. They're my boss. I work for them. But that generation can't say it. If you said to Bob, tell me, Bob, look into my eyes and tell me that Teofimo Lopez is your boss, do you think he could say it?
No.
He couldn't say that.
I don't think so.
But I'll tell you this. On November the 27th, at Madison Square Garden on DAZN, Teofimo Lopez is my boss.
Can you look at Teo and say he's undisputed?
And say he's undisputed?
No. We won't do that yet.
Wow. Yeah, but the fight is promoted as undisputed. Everybody knows.
I'll tell you, as I said,
the fight is promoted as undisputed.
November 27th, I work for him. No shame in that. He's just a promoter. He's the fighter. He's the star.
And then February 2.
Because at the end of the day, at least someone understands it, is this. He can't eat without the fighters. We can't eat without the promoters.
Exactly.
Well, you can always eat because you're the talent. Doesn't matter who's
promoting
you.
Thank you. That's true what he says. Yeah. But he's talking about platform wise.
Yeah, but I promise you this. To make this happen, we ain't going to be making a load of money on November 27th, but we get to promote it.
Hold on. Wait. Chill. Check the viewership. I'm going
to
tell you.
Oh, yeah. You can't lie to us about the viewership.
No,
please.
But that's for this.
Because I want to shut up TMT.
I want to make this happen. So I don't care about making money on this show. I want to be involved in the fight. I want to work with you guys. I want to bring you to DAZN. Job done for me. All right? So the rest is up to you.
Yeah.
The girl that you saw working earlier.
Yeah.
Tia works with all the kids.
Yes. That's tremendous. What we do. We give back all the time.
Except Caleb Plant and Tia.
As you know, boxing changes lives.
Yes.
It saves lives.
Saves a lot of lives. Yeah.
And, you know, you see another example of that girl where boxing has saved their life.
Yes.
Really.
Yes.
So whether it's an opportunity to become a professional or just to get some discipline and structure and respect in your life, boxing has the opportunity to do that. But not enough people see that.
Put a fair game into it so everybody gets a chance, Just a few. Thank you.
Yeah, I want to thank everybody for coming, and I just want to say it's a blessing to be with the Zone.
One more question for my enemy.
You know, an association.
So everyone, please, get back there.
Yeah, but I just want to thank everybody. And I want to tell
Thanks
Eddie,
for coming out, guys.
We got to see the numbers, Eddie, because a lot of people talking a lot of shit that we don't do numbers. We don't put,
we don't put
asses in the seats.
Yeah.
We got to stop that already. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, they got bigger people that have been in the game for long, and because they say that, people believe it. You know what I'm saying? We did 4.2 million views on ESPN with the Lomachenko fight. And everybody knows that about that, you know? So I just want to put that out in the clear. We want to see the numbers that night.
Mr. ESPN over there, Mike Coppinger as well. You know?
There you go. So, what, the break?
Last one.
That was kind of fun. what did he say that got you over?
He said about the rematch clause.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's my job, is to create opportunities for the fighters. If I can get a rematch clause in a 50-50 fight, that's what I'm going to do. Devin Haney's the world champion. He's having a voluntary defense against Jojo Diaz. It's not unusual to have a rematch clause.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Doesn't mean I think he's going to lose. So
that's what he was talking about.
Yeah.
So speaking of that fight, Jojo's coming off a monstrous win against Fortuna.
Yeah.
It kind of got made, I feel like, on Twitter, the fight,
that was a final eliminator for Devin Haney, Fortuna fight. So when he won, we went, great. You know, we're going to fight Devin Haney with Jojo Diaz. And then he went and signed to fight Ryan Garcia, and we're like, Ryan Garcia fought a final eliminator to fight Devin Haney and didn't fight him. And then the Ryan Garcia fight fell through, and I said, now you got to fight. So we made the same offer that he was getting, ended up paying more. But there was nowhere to run. But JoJo's a real fighter, you know, it's a great fighter.
Last one, Dillian White pulled out. Just first, how is he doing? And do you really expect the WBC to
I do. I think I'm certain the WBC will order that mandatory with Tyson Fury. They'll do that at their convention. Dillian's going to have about another 3 or 4 weeks of treatment. He just couldn't fight. He wanted to fight. He's going to end up having a year out between the fights. That's not ideal. He was making a lot of money. He was ready to fight. But he'll be ready for Tyson Fury.
Do you think Fury will go along with them? He seems kind of on top of the world.
And, yeah, but it's a great fight. It's a great fight. He made loads of money. He'll make a load of money. He'll believe he can win the fight. This is mandatory. It's what you do as a champion. I think people need to put more pressure on him to take the fight.
Thank you.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.